Welcome to the Solo Grind, where we shine a light on the raw and real journey of being a solo entrepreneur. I am Teresa, your guide on this adventure of going it alone, without a safety net, and without the rule book. The grind is real, my friend, and so are the wins, the freedom, and the joy of building success on your own terms. I'm here to debunk the myths, share some laughs, and share what it takes to thrive as a go-getter, busy doing it all entrepreneur. Hello and welcome to this episode of The Solo Grind. For those of you joining me for the very first time, I am Teresa Schloop, your host and the original caffeine creative. I know firsthand what it feels like to have a dream so big that those around me can't see it. And I know what it's like to continue pushing that needle forward even when people think we're crazy. Like you, I am a busy doing-it-all entrepreneur, simply trying to make my corner of the world a better place, and I do that by helping other entrepreneurs, confident female solo entrepreneurs, stand out through personal branding, website design, and strategic marketing. You can think of me as your business bestie by your side. And today's topic is diving into how are we spending our time. And what I really want you to think about as we go through today's content is to get clarity on, are you being productive or are you wasting your time and just being busy for the sake of being busy? As a solo entrepreneur, there is always something to do, whether it takes care of scheduling meetings, getting our emails done, writing proposals, or just managing the day-to-day. There is a never-ending to-do list that always seems to be getting longer. And that's just the day-to-day. We also have to step into that big picture role as a CEO and look at our business, how we're making an impact, how we want to grow, and what changes we want to make coming up. It's pretty easy to be busy as an entrepreneur, but are you being busy or are you wasting your time? Not all activity that we do is productive. Some of it is simply disguised as progress, but it's actually keeping us from moving the needle forward. And so that is what we're going to dive into today. But before we do that, I thought I would start sharing something a little different at the start of my episodes. And that is essentially things I wish I had known or believed before I started my business. There are so many lessons I wish that I had learned along the way that would have made my life a lot easier had I just known or trusted them from the beginning. So I thought I'd start sharing those with you here, as we're all here to make the best of this solo entrepreneurial world. And today's little nugget of wisdom is really about prioritizing relationship building over busy work. Early on, I focused so much on the technology of my business, creating posts, creating graphics, creating my website, redoing my logo, all the things. Some of this we're going to even talk about here in today's episode. And I spent a lot of time behind the screen, not getting out there where my people are at. And here's the thing. I really thought I was being busy. I thought I was being productive. I thought I was building a foundation for my business, but I was forgetting the most crucial part of my business, and that is the clients that are here wanting to hire me. If we are relying 100% on technology to do the heavy lifting for us, we're not building a business. We have a hobby with a lot of techie work behind the scenes. So rather than focusing so much on the tech and hoping that it takes care of getting my business out there, I wish I'd have known that I should get myself out there and start making some real life connections with the people that I'm here to serve. Don't get me wrong, those things matter. Our online presence, our branding, our website design, all very important tools within our business, but none of them move the needle forward as well as or as fast as making real life connections with people we are here to serve. Now, if you have a nugget of wisdom that you would like to share or a pressing question you would love to ask me to be included in one of our future episodes, please reach out. Let me know. All of my contact information is in the show notes, and I would love to hear what you're interested in learning. Okay, so now let's dive into today's topic. And we're going to do so by starting off with playing a little game. Am I busy or productive? It's easy. I am going to share two statements for a couple different areas in business, and you simply pick which statement you can relate to the most or that is most often true for you. All right, so number one, which of these sound more like you? I spent an hour getting my social media graphics and images created and scheduled for next week. Or I just spent an hour creating one Canva post. Number two, I focused on creating valuable content for my audience today. Or I just spent hours scrolling through social media to see what everybody else is doing. For marketing research, of course. Number three, I'm focusing on fine-tuning and developing processes for my services that I'm currently offering. Or I just bought up a bunch of domain names for projects that I'm going to get to someday. Number, let's see, which number are we on? Four, five? I am optimizing my website for better results. Or I am tweaking my website content again. All right, I've lost count. So we're just going to say the next one. I have been able to apply what I learned from these courses that I just took to make my business more productive and or efficient. Or is this sound more like you? I haven't implemented anything yet, but I will someday. All right, two more questions here for you. I am using the tools I already have effectively to help my business run smoothly. Or I just signed up for the new software trend that I will implement someday. All right, final statement here or question. Which of these sounds more like you? I'm giving most of my time and energy in marketing to proven strategies. Or I'm constantly shifting my focus and chasing the new marketing trend. So as you can see, in each one of these scenarios, one of the statements is productive and one is simply busy for the sake of being busy. And that is one of the traps that we all fall into, my friend, where we are focused on being busy and creating and doing all the things that we tell ourselves we have to do, and most of it is not actually moving the needle forward. This busyness trap is what keeps us stuck, and it's what keeps us from growing our business when that's exactly what we're here to do. So let's take a look at why. I'm going to share with you seven reasons why we fall into that busyness trap of wasting time and hopping down a rabbit hole of inefficient time use. And I'm going to give you some insights into how to assess, is this actually what I'm falling into? Is this what I'm dealing with? And I'm even going to offer some resources if this is a trap you fall into often that you can go to help you move beyond this trap. All right, so first, let's take a look at the seven main reasons. They are perfectionism, a fear of failure, procrastination in disguise, lack of clear priorities, a distraction by trends, and let's see, over-reliance on busy work and the fear of delegation. All right, so let's take a look at perfectionism first. Now, I am all about doing things well. In fact, I am all about doing things with excellence. I love to take a task, no matter what it is, whether it's building a website or creating a box of cookies for somebody that I love. I am all about doing that really, really well and with a level of excellence that gives me satisfaction. And that is part of my personality. But there is a line that needs to be drawn that really is between that line between perfection and mastery. Okay. Perfectionism keeps us stuck. Perfectionism shows up in our businesses in ways such as constantly tweaking our website or redoing our logo and second guessing our branding colors. It's spending an hour on one Instagram post or redefining our services once again, even though we've been down that road many, many times before. So instead of striving for perfectionism, I seek to strive for a mastery. And mastery is different than perfectionism. Perfectionism is being stalled, it's being stuck, it's being caught up in, honestly, fear of failure, which is what we're going to talk about next. But mastery is all about doing, learning, growing, refining, and doing it again. It's about taking action, taking a look at what we've created, what action we've done, asking ourselves, how can I make this better? Refining the process and doing it all over again. And each time getting just a little bit better. It's kind of like the story that we told a couple weeks ago about the entrepreneurs, Sally and Mary. One achieved business success really relatively quickly with a lot of hard work by getting out there and doing and striving for mastery, whereas the other got stuck in perfectionism, got stuck in the fear of failure, got stuck in wanting to get things right, and never truly launched her business. So instead of getting stuck and trying to be perfect, embrace those imperfections and know that they're part of the journey. There are so many things that I have done over the years that are far from perfect. In fact, I was just talking to a friend of mine the other day about how I listened to the first couple episodes of this podcast, and a couple of them honestly were kind of cringy to me because they were not what I wanted to do. That being said, they still work to support my business and what I want to accomplish with the Solo Grind podcast, because they resonated with people, they connected with people, and they achieved the goal that I wanted. Were they perfect in my eyes? No, they were far from perfect, but they accomplished what I wanted them to accomplish, and I feel like I've gotten better at putting together this podcast. So that is that difference that we need to look at from the perfection to mastery. Okay. Now, if you find yourself really struggling with perfection, like if this is one of those hurdles that you were just having a really difficult time getting past and you just can't seem to get over it, the book that I want to recommend for you to do, and all of these recommendations for support that I'm going to share with you today are books, because that's one of the best places that you can learn a lot for a very small investment. But the book I want to recommend today is The Gifts of Imperfection by Brené Brown. Brené Brown has a lot of great, valuable insights to share. And this, I think, is one of her better books because she really helps you understand how perfectionism can masquerade as productivity and how it leads us into spending time on tasks that really don't move us closer to our goals. So again, I'll list this in the show notes so you can go take a look at that. But if perfectionism is where you're stuck, this is a great book to help you get unstuck. All right, now perfectionism often is actually part of this next one that I want to talk about, and that is that fear of failure. We strive for perfection because we have this idea in the back of our minds that if we are so perfect and so spot on and so amazing, there's no possible way that we will fail. Well, here's something that I want you to know. If you put yourself out there, if you are giving your best, what you have right now in this moment, giving the best to the people you're here to serve, you didn't fail. Was it as great and fabulous as you wanted it to be? Not. That's where mastery comes into place. But it's not a failure. Stepping out and giving your best to the world around you is always success. And it's something that I want you to really think about, because when we start getting afraid of what other people think, and I think that's where the biggest fear of failure comes in. What are people going to think? What are people going to say? What are people going to do? Honestly, most people aren't thinking harshly about us. When we step out and do something, you know, just bold and audacious and different from everybody else, they're looking at us like, wow, I'm amazed. She is incredible. She is courageous. She is brave. I wish I could be more like her. The people who are being overly critical not your people for your inner circle. Okay. Yes, there are times that I've had people who would be like, oh my God, I can't believe you did that. Why would you do that? I would be so embarrassed. That's their fear talking. You don't have to listen to it. Okay. So don't worry about what people are thinking. And it's a lot easier said than done. And it's really hard to figure out how to get past that hurdle of that fear of failure because everybody's journey is a little bit different. But my suggestion is silence the noise and believe in yourself and take a step forward. I guarantee it's going to be more incredible than you imagined. Now, if that fear of failure is one that you get really, really stuck with, okay, I want you to take a look for or look for the book called Mindset, The New Psychology of Success by Carol Dweck. Now, she, in her book, Carol explores the idea that fear of failure is what leads us to the avoidance of challenging tasks. It's what keeps us stuck. It's what keeps us focused on the smaller, insignificant tasks that have little impact on the actual growth and forward movement of our goals. So again, if the fear of failure is the hurdle you just can't get beyond to move things forward, then I want you to take a look at Carol Dweck's book, The Mindset or Mindset, The New Psychology of Success. Okay. Now we're going to jump into procrastination in disguise. I think this is one that I can fall into the most, in all honesty, and that is becoming hyper fixated on a task that is a very busy task. It's a very action oriented task, and I'm really doing something. And at the end of the day, I honestly don't have a whole lot to show for what I did. I might have checked off a lot of boxes or completed some to-do lists, but I didn't actually do anything that is going to help grow my business, support my clients, or help me grow my audience. And so that's one that I definitely get caught up in. And that's procrastination in disguise. We believe that we're being busy. We believe that we're creating a productive day or that we're doing things and getting things done. But honestly, we're focusing way too much time on less important tasks. And my number one procrastination in disguise activity is to-do lists. I love writing to-do lists. I have actually created lists that I need to create. And I'm not even exaggerating. It's something that honestly my husband laughs at me about because it is ridiculous. But if you were to come see me on a Sunday morning, you will see me curled up with my planner and a notebook in hand alongside my cup of coffee writing out to-do lists. It is kind of ridiculous and really hilarious. It's something my husband actually teases me about, and he has every right to do so because I am just all about the to-do list. Some other ways that procrastination in disguise shows up in my life or the lives of others probably, or I know for sure, is endlessly researching, spending hours and hours and hours reading and researching and preparing for a project, going far beyond what is necessary just for the sake of feeling productive, revising, tweaking. We've already talked about that quite a bit. Your brand, your website, your social media content, constantly getting stuck in that idea of perfectionism. Learning without action. Here's a big one that I think a lot of us do, and I see this happening often, is we learn, but we don't take action on what we learn. That is procrastination in disguise. Now, if these resonate with you and you feel like this is definitely who you are, then I would say the book that you want to take a look at is Eat That Frog by Brian Tracy. In this book, he offers some really amazing practical advice on how to overcome procrastination and explain how we get engaged in that disguised procrastination, how it keeps us stuck. All right. So let's take a look at the next one here, and that is having a clear lack of priorities, or a lack of clear priorities, I should say. That one is one that's a little bit harder to pinpoint, I think, because we believe, especially when we are doing it all entrepreneurs, we believe that all the tasks are important and they all need to be done. But there is a list of priorities. Like there is a level of priorities to take into account, especially when we're incredibly busy. So let's say you've had a really awesome, incredibly busy week where you've been doing lots of client work, and you're getting to the end of the week and you're getting to the end of what you have to give in energy and into the business, and you haven't really done anything with your social media marketing for next week. All right, now you have to face a choice. Do you ignore finishing up with your clients? Or do you ignore being perfect in your social media or getting your social media done? Which is a higher priority? Obviously, the people paying you, the people who believe in you, the people who are investing in you and your business are the higher priority. However, we'll get stuck thinking that social media is more important than it is. So, getting really clear on what are our priorities. And for me, honestly, every single day, I will list out what are my priorities for that day. And it's never more than a couple, two or three tops. And sometimes it's only one. The key is to figure out what tasks do you need to accomplish to make your business profitable and successful. All right. Once you figure that out, then you know what your priorities are. Now, if this is something that you are struggling with, the book that I'm going to recommend for you is First Things First, and that is by Stephen R. Covey, Roger Merrill, and Rebecca Merrill. And this book is really fabulous because not only does it help you prioritize clearly, but it helps you align your priorities with your values and what is going to contribute to your long-term goals the most. All right. It's an old school book, but it's definitely one worth reading if you struggle with creating priorities. And if you want a shortcut, you want to bypass this book, although it's a great book and definitely worth the read, then I would encourage you to look up the First Things First Big Rocks video with Stephen Covey in it, because that is really going to illustrate how to create the right priorities in your life and how the fillers are just not as important as we think they are. All right, so now let's move on to number five, distraction by trends. All right. This is a big one, especially this time of the year. There's a lot of noise out there about the new software, new upgrades, new marketing trends, new things that you have to do to be successful in the new year. And we're going to start getting inundated with ads from and for Black Friday sales and all these kind of things. All right. Here's the thing that I want to say about the trends. While all of them have value, all of them have something to give to the world, whether we recognize that or not, we don't have to participate in all of them. Sometimes what we are doing when it works really well is where we need to stay. All right. So don't get caught up in trying to dive into the new latest trend. In fact, before you dive into the new latest trend, I would ask, stop and ask yourself, how is this going to help improve my business? Is it going to add value or efficiency to my business? Is it going to add value to my dream customers, to my audience? Is it something that I have time to emphasize or to implement or have time to give, devote to it? If you can't devote time, then it's definitely not something that we need to focus on and definitely not something you need to do right now. So, if that distraction by trends is one that is really getting you caught up, the book that I want to recommend is Deep Work: Rules for Focused Success in a Distracted World. And this comes to us from Cal Newport, who is really good at showing how that constant need to chase the latest trends actually leads to some pretty shallow and unproductive work and rarely leads to any real progress in our businesses. All right, now we're going to get to busy work because this is a big one that gets a lot of us caught, and it's where we waste a lot of time on busy work. And we've talked about some of this, like countless times, you know, countless hours spent reorganizing blog posts or working on Canva posts or whatever. We've been over all of it. The book that I recommend, if you are just stuck in busy, frivolous work that is truly not all that productive, then I want you to take a look at The 4-Hour Workweek by Tim Ferriss. Tim honestly helps you figure out how to optimize your tasks and create incredible boundaries. And one productivity tip or example from Tim's book is instead of spending hours in your email every day trying to keep up with the noise in there, check it once a day. Or I think he even maybe checks it once a week, which I'm not quite up with that. I communicate with email very much or quite often. And so once, twice a day is what I do. But the key here is focusing on what really is going to make our business successful and not focusing on deleting spam from our inbox. That can be done once a day, and that's all the time we need to give to it. Okay. So now we're going to dive into the very last thing that keeps us from being productive and makes it easy for us to waste time and not move the needle forward. And that is a fear of delegation. Now, I understand we are all solo entrepreneurs here. We've shared that. I've also shared in the past that while I am a solo entrepreneur, I am a 95% girl. I do not do 100% of the things in my business. In fact, I have people that I rely on and delegate tasks to. Okay. I have an associate designer who takes care of a lot of my graphic design and things like that behind the scenes. I have an admin person that helps ensure that I am communicating effectively with my clientele because sometimes I get busy and she is there to make sure that the necessary communications are sent out throughout the year. I have people who take care of filing my state income taxes and an accountant that does things. We don't have to do everything. And in fact, we should be delegating or outsourcing the things that drain us, exhaust us, or that we simply just cannot do well. So if fear of delegation is where you find yourself getting stuck, then I really encourage you to take a look at the book, The E-Myth Revisited by Michael Gerber. And here, this is where Michael dives into how and why small business owners are struggling with delegation and how it leads them to wasting a lot of time. One of the things that I learned years ago from one of my mentors and good friends is she said, when you hire the right person to take care of the tasks you hate to do, they will more than pay for themselves and the time you get back. And that is so very true, my friend. Hire things out. You don't have to do everything yourself. Whew, that was a lot of information. And thank you so much for sticking with me on this episode. I know I threw a lot at you and gave you a lot of things to think about, but I think there's power in understanding where we get stuck and understanding when we are caught up in busy tasks that don't move the needle forward versus actually being productive. So again, thank you so much for being here today. And be sure to join us next week where we will be joined with another special guest, my good friend and fellow podcast host, the incredible Emily Aborn. Emily is a small business copywriter and the host of the podcast Content with Character and just a treasure trove of incredible wisdom and knowledge. I honestly think I learn something from her every single week, if not every day. So you definitely want to be here to see what she has to share. Thank you again for tuning in. And until we meet again, I hope you have the most amazing week ahead. Thanks for tuning in to The Solo Grind. I hope this episode brought you some inspiration and encouragement. If you enjoyed it, please subscribe, rate, and review the podcast, and feel free to share. For more tips and insights, visit caffeinecreative.io to check out my blog or explore The Creative Vault, my free course library. You can also find me on Facebook and Instagram. I'd love to hear how this episode has helped you.